here years ago, I want to say. Feel because we're celebrating the 80s, let's get in the 80s vibe. So during like the Q&A, put the phones away.
Go on my left side.
And then our other very special guest, the singer of the most amazing song in the whole entire world.
Life's journey that was important to so many people involved in the film. It was staggering to watch the production and the team, the huge team. And you know, being involved in music can be a big project, making albums, organizing musicians, and you go to gigs.
What is it, Slow Horses?
Yeah.
So it's the company that made that, which is really like, you know, but they're great.
Right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
So it's very relevant, you know, and it's great. The documentary just fits perfectly in all of that.
Yay!
It really does. Round of applause for these.
Come on. Why don't throw it out to the audience? Who has a question?
Little role, and then I just feel like somehow with the sort of 80s nostalgia thing wave picking up, and then me going to comic cons and talking to people and hearing how much it influenced them, that's when I realized it. So maybe I missed the train, but like for me it just felt like something that grew slowly over time. That was my experience of it. I'm not saying that's how it was, you know.
Same, even though I just had this like number one with Kajagoogoo all over the world, it was an audition. I thought, he's auditioning me? I'm just on number one. Who does he think he is? But yeah, a week later, they said, yeah, he likes the vocal. It's going to get used. And then, of course, a few months later, I went back and shot the video. No idea that it was going to be this blossoming, beautiful flower. As I said to somebody upstairs, the song gets streamed on average at the moment on Spotify, I don't know about the other streaming sites, 2.3 million times a month. Because it was a global number one. And the all-time streams are about 130 million. Like, so far. So, keeps the phone ringing. Back to the film.
I don't know, you know, I really liked adults that talked to me like I was a human being, and I could always feel when adults were kind of like putting on a saccharine voice for me or dumbing things down for me, and I found that really insulting, and I didn't like it. And so that Wolfgang was the opposite of that. He just spoke to me like an adult, you know, and he was very, he wanted it right, and he wanted you to hit your marks. It was very precise. And there was a kind of, you know, you need to look here on this moment, you need to look here on this moment, and the sort of technical precision of that, and the expectation that you will be able to do it. Like, I appreciated that. So I feel so lucky that I got to work with him. And I've worked on lots of plays over the years.
Yeah. We were 100%
correct. What character did Jason James